This is a video from everystepcalculus.com demonstrating how my programs work on a TI-89 titanium calculator and other calculators in the TI system for physics and calculus problems. Okay, Simpson's Rule, an approximation on a definite integral. And let's get started. You press second alpha to put the letters I, N, D, E, X in here. You press alpha and put the 9 in the open and close parentheses. Press enter and you're into my menu. Many choices here for you to pass your Calculus 2 class. We're going to do Simpson's Rule. And we're going to do what's up here in the example. This was on the YouTube by one person, professor, or whoever. And so we're going to enter that. You have to press alpha before you enter anything into my entry lines of my program. So I'm going to press alpha and put the 1 divided by, of course, always parentheses, x to the 5th plus 1, close off the parentheses, press enter. I always show you what you've entered so you can change in case you've made a mistake. And we're going to put in our range, alpha 2 to alpha 7. Again, I show you. I say it's okay. Here's the Simpson rule formula right out of the calculus books. Doesn't tell you much. Took me 2 days to figure the real formula out, which is this. And you write this on your paper here. I don't think it'll appear in a test. It's too difficult, but probably for homework. We're going to do 6 intervals, and change of x is b minus a, that's the upper limit minus the lower, divided by the number of intervals, and that equals 0.833. And we start our calculations according to the formula, and you write this all on your paper. I'm going to do it quickly here. Notice this is changing, substituting in for x to the 5 plus 1 each time. And then you sum up all the calculations. If you write this on your paper, you're going to look like a genius. 1.12 square units, which is the area of that definite integral. Pretty neat, huh? Everystepcalculus.com. Go to my site, buy my programs, and pass calculus.